Hi Smart Cookies, today you are going to watch a little girl narrating her experience about her first train journey to her father. So imagine me as a little girl. I know it's quite difficult, but still, no other go, you have to bear with me. So now, lend me your ears, I will not take much of your time. Daddy, do you know we had been to Kerala recently? Mom and I booked a taxi and reached the central station at 8 o'clock in the morning. And I was so excited to see a crowd of people and many trains were on the platform about to depart. So Mom showed the timetable board and we checked whether our train is on time or is there any delay. She showed me the train ticket which we had already reserved and she asked me to see the coach number and the seat number. Then we reached the right platform. We traced the coach number and the seat number. We boarded the train and we sat comfortably on our seats. Mine was a window seat and Mom's seat was an aisle seat. And we placed our luggage on the luggage rack. And I was very happy to get the window seat because during the journey, I watched the green pastures, meadows, rocky mountains, fields, cows, cattle, and so many natural scenery. It was so admirable and enjoyable. If you had been there, I would have enjoyed a lot. And Mom's seat was an aisle seat. Do you know, Dad, what an aisle seat is? The meaning of aisle is actually it is a path between two rows of seats. See, path will be there in the middle and this side will be rows of seats and this side also will be the rows of seats. You can find it even in buses, flights and even in wedding ceremonies. That aisle will be there for the bride and bridegroom to walk over. So, that is called aisle. So, Mom's seat was an aisle seat. And she showed me the sleeper car, the sitter car, the pantry car. And do you know the use of sleeper car, Dad? Sleeper car, actually, they are booked by the passengers who need to travel long distances as they could not sit for a long time. They can sleep on the upper berth or the middle berth or the lower berth. And the sitter cars, car mean don't think it is a four-wheeler. Car is actually another name for wagon or compartment, or you can call coach also. So in the sleeper sitter car, passengers who travel short distances, they reserve in sitter cars. And she also told me the first compartment of the train is an engine and the last van of the train is called a caboose. So, I learned that new word from my mom on the day, Dad. And also, she told me about the vestibule. Do you know what a vestibule is? Actually, vestibule connects one compartment and the next compartment. Even the express trains, actually, they don't stop at different stations for a long time. They stop only in minimal stations and it will not stop for a long time. It will be there just less than 5 minutes. So even some passengers who get down to buy food or water, they can board into any coaches and through the vestibules they can reach their assigned seats. So vestibules are created for the passengers' facility. They can board into any coach and they can reach their assigned seats. So that is, and again she explained me about the pantry car. So pantry car is nothing but kitchen. The travelers, the passengers, they order food and the suppliers will supply food for us and they walk through the aisle and they can easily go from the first coach to the last coach using the vestibule. The train ticket examiner visited our coach. he checked our tickets and gave back to us. And mom and I shared a lot of stories. We enjoyed watching outside through the window. And some vendors also came selling some goods. And after 8 hours of time, we reached our destination. We got off the train and then we went to our grandma's house and enjoyed a lot there.